Lowe's, I found these 20-foot section pieces of tubing, and I wanted more than 20 foot, but to get it by the roll, it was more expensive. So I just got two of these, and I'm gonna put them together by using this piece of vinyl tubing that I had for some other stuff, my water sanitization projects for the RV. Anyway, I'm gonna slip it in here because I want it smooth as possible, and join these two pieces together to make a 40-foot section for the water level. So I just took a screwdriver here and I stuck it in and kind of moved it around just a little bit to wall it out a little bit, one side at a time. Then I lubricated it with a lubricating solution. I spit on it. And then I stuck it in one side, did the same on the other, and put the two together. So now I've got 40 foot of tubing. Okay, this is the container I'm using to hold the liquid for the water level. And I believe it's going to be big enough. This is one of the big creamer containers. And I'm going to use it, but I want to make it to where I can store the tubing inside of it when it's not in use, you know, to keep it nice and clean and neat, tidy and all that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill two holes in there with a 3/8 inch bit here, and I'm going to use the top hat grommets that I used when I did the fawn systems, and also I'm going to use one of these sprinklers. This is a drip irrigation sprinkler type head, and I'm going to use that to plug an end. That way no water is lost when I'm using it. And then the best way to kind of show you what I'm talking about is to actually show you. So I explain that this is what I'm going to do. Now I'm going to show you. I'm going to drill two holes. I'm going to put the top hat grommets in, and we'll go from there. All right, there are the two top hat grommets with the tubing going through it. That's what it looks like on the outside, and this is what it looks like on the inside. You can see down, let me see if I can see in this. Yeah, right there is the inlet, the short tube. That's where the water is going to go into the tubing, and because it's adding on this side, it's hard to see with the sun, because on this side I can wrap the tubing and then put the top back on it and store it. On the end, I have it capped with that drip sprayer. This one, this kind, when it's closed all the way down, off, it should create a vacuum which will allow the water to stay in the tube. And then when I open it, as if water is coming out, it should allow air to get in there and make an effective level. But we'll do all that in the testing part. For now, I need to fill this with water and check to see if there are any leaks. All right, I have filled it, well, to approximately what I think it'll be with the hose displacing the water. And it's got, it's dry here now, and it's dry here now, but I'm going to leave it for a while. The deck is dry underneath, so I can check. It'll be easy to tell if it's leaking because the deck will be wet. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave it for some time and then come back and check it. So I've filled it with water, as you can see, but what I need to do is color that water so it's easily detectable inside the tube for water leveling purposes. And normally you would use a food coloring to do that, but we don't have food coloring. Gina just doesn't use it for any of her cooking. But what I did find was a really old packet of Kool-Aid. It doesn't have the sugar in it. It's not, you know, one of those artificial sweeteners in it. It's just color and whatever makes it taste like grape. So I'm going to pour that in here. We're going to mix that in, and that's going to be my food coloring or notification of where the water level is so I can see it easily enough. So there you go. My adapt and overcome version of food coloring with the additional pleasant nice grape smell. So every time I use it, I'll know it's Kool-Aid. Oh. So I filled it a little fuller, and that's so the liquid going into the tube, there'll be enough displacement when the tube goes in, and the liquid will be full. And you can see there's no, well, this is dripping from when I filled it. There's no leaking coming from the top head grommet. So, all right, I got the board set up. Now, right now this is closed off, this fitting. And so what I'm hoping happens is when I open this, it's just gonna come out. But my experience tells me and my general knowledge tells me that it needs to be a siphon before that'll happen. So there we go. It's fully open now. And so what I'm hoping is I can tilt this enough so it goes up the tube and then starts the process. Well, I had to do a little bit of sucking on it. Now, this is, since this is lower and it is going, eventually it's going to come out here. So let's wait for that. And that's my wife feeding the cat again for some reason. Gets fed every day at 5. So let me bring you around here. I'm going to show you what's happening. Let's see. Oh, here it is. It's already up here. Yep. Here it is. I knew I saw it. It's already going around. It's even got some junk in it. Hopefully that junk will come out. All right, so that's it. It is completely coming out the tube here, so I should be able to hold it up above the water, and you'll see that this line will automatically settle where the water level, see the line there? It automatically settle where the water level is. And that's the great thing about water. It will always find level. Just all you have to do is stabilize it, take the hose wherever you want to take the end of the hose, and it will always find the same level here. So let me cap this off, turn off the video, cap this off so it doesn't drain back out, and we will continue with the build. Okay, I am a good ways away from it, and I'll just show you here where we're at. You can see the level here. I've turned this open, and so there, anytime you move this, the water is going to drop in the tube or rise in the tube to the exact same level as the water that's in that container over there. And water leveling is pretty dang awesome, isn't it? So let me lower this with my hand, and you can see it rising. It's going to rise until it reaches level again. So I can do this. Now I can close this off and it creates a vacuum and it won't rise or lower anymore. And that's good for just moving around or throwing it on the ground or whatever you need until you use it. So what I'm doing now is I'm wrapping the tubing for storage, simulated storage. And we're gonna see if the water, how much the water level, the Kool-Aid water level rises from the displacement of the hose. And I wanted to show you that hopefully I'm able to succeed in getting this tubing in the hole. Now remember, it's 40 feet, so it's a good bit. It's a good bit of tubing. So I'm gonna put this in first, and we're gonna come back for the rest of it. All right. Now I can already tell there's. Well, let me show you that I'm gonna need to pour a little bit of that out. So let's do that. Whoop. Camera's sitting on a board, so professional videoing going on. All right, so now let's finish. Got about 10 more feet or so, 8 more feet, something like that. And then we'll have this thing done, set up for storage, and hopefully you'll get to see that I'm not such a dummy. for doing or coming up with this concept. All in practical use right now in front of you. So, okay, there's a couple lips in there. And there you have it. And I'll just put this top on. And now we can just haul it over and put it on a shelf until we need to use it again. Keeps the water and Kool-Aid and everything in there fresh. Well, keeps debris and stuff out and stores well. All right, this has been sitting here for a long time and it is not wet, so we don't have any leakage, at least for now. So the next thing we need to do is to mark it. Obviously, this is going to indicate that it's a water level for me in the future, but if it's turned around or something else, well, it just looks better if it has a nice label on it. All right, now how to use the darn thing, right? So what I've got here is a piece of trim. It's just a leftover straight piece of narrow trim that I'd used a long time ago. And what I wanted to use was like a 3 foot yard ruler made of wood. That way it would have the measurements on it. But I'm gonna show you this, what I've done here and how this will be useful. Basically, any type of straight object that is rigid will help you secure a level on all areas that you're going for. So I use this trim, you could use PVC, you could use anything you want. You can either tie it to it or tape it. I used painter's tape here so it can come off easily enough and I can reuse it if I want to later. Really, I just found this piece of scrap wood just for this demonstration. So what we're gonna do is to measure the height at this end of the greenhouse compared to that end of the greenhouse, and I'll show you how to level it if you were going to want that whole thing actually level. And the reason why I'm building this water level to begin with is because in my new greenhouse over there, when it gets built, plus this one here on the end, I'm going to redo the water culture beds. I want to make sure that I have a level platform before I put the structures down that the fawn platforms are going to go on. So what we're going to do is we're going to find the highest part, highest end. It's either going to be this end or this end. So let's go do that. All right, you want the container to be above at a higher level than any of what you're doing at all. So the water level is going to be within the stick parameter. So what I did was I took and I put it on top of that tote here and I measured the water level. I looked at the water level and I put a line here. Actually, it was over here. Where was it? Anyway, it was right here. I'll readjust the line here, but actually I won't. It's good enough. So you can see here that it's slightly above the tape. That's the water line right now. So we're going to carry it to the other end. We're going to look at it. All right, we've come almost the distance of the greenhouse. We didn't have quite enough tubing to go the full 40 feet of the greenhouse. But what you can see here is if you follow it up, you can see the water line was up here and now it's down here. So it's pretty dang close to level already. And if you want to make sure where it's level, if you need to lower or raise, you raise above the dirt or go into the dirt to make it true level, you look at your mark. If you raise it a little bit, see how it goes down, you know that this end over here is higher than the other end. So what you would need to do is actually dig the dirt out some, and that would raise this level up to where it was over here, right about here. So that's an example of how to use the water level without a measuring. If you want to get precise, you can put measuring like a ruler on here, use a yardstick, which is probably what I'll end up doing eventually. But for now, in the purpose of this video, it's just a good tutorial on how to use and how I'm going to use this water level to find true level, because water is always level, always finds level. Okay, I coiled it in. I found out it's a lot easier to do if you just coil it as you pull it in, and plenty of area to easily close the cap. Don't forget to turn off your valve if you're using a valve, so the water doesn't come flowing out as you coil it back up for storage. All right, I put it on the floor inside the winter greenhouse here. It's temperature controlled. It's a good place for it. It's on the floor, and this is kind of where we'll keep it until I need it for the greenhouses and stuff as spring approaches. Sprint, you guys. We'll see you later.